And come on, guys, who launches a ground attack in winter in Russia? Now, in November, the Germans launched a new attack on Moscow. The Soviet army held their ground and brought the Germans to a halt. Stalin insisted on a counterattack, and although his commanders had doubts, they launched their own offensive on December 4th. The Germans caught off guard and demoralized by the recent defeat, but pushed back and began retreating. By January, they'd been pushed back nearly 200 miles. So, hey, that's what happens when you attack in Russia in the middle of winter. But this is a great piece. It's one of the most widely played pieces on what we have as called prescribed music list. And it's a really fun thing to push and challenge these kids this early in the year. And they've done a fantastic job with it. So we hope you enjoy Moscow, 1941. We are an all-volunteer group based in Wimberley. By that I mean we rehearse 3 times a month in Wimberley, and then we actually have to rehearse 1 time a month at my school, which is perfectly fine. And it's not a bad drive for me because I actually live in Wimberley, so I'm excited about this. But again, an all-volunteer group, open to anybody of any ability level. If you have an instrument in your closet that you haven't touched in 10, 20 years, that's okay. Come see us. And we'll have some fun and make some music together. The first piece we played is called In Autumn Skies. It is an American-style concert march, quick-step march, written by a Japanese guy. Where I guess it's his idea of what an American march should sound like. Kind of close. But it's a lot of fun and really energetic. This next piece we're going to play for you is by a wonderful young composer named Michael Murkowski. It's one of his more recent works. It's called Shine. Thank you. Now we're going to do something slower because my arms need a break. That's just a wonderfully exciting piece. The next piece we're going to play for you is absolutely gorgeous, written by one of my favorite contemporary composers that's writing a lot of really good stuff for different levels of bands. In fact, one of his pieces that I do almost every single year is something I do with my beginners on their spring concert. It's called Rising Star, and it's cool because it sounds so deep and complex, and it only uses six notes. And I think that's brilliant. And then he has stuff all the way up to just some of the most difficult stuff you can possibly imagine. Like, this is right in between kind of the line. It doesn't look technically difficult, but it has a lot of musicality and a lot of control that's required in the performance. So this is a piece by Samuel Hazo called In Heaven's Air.
Thank you.
for you to play because it incorporates some extra musical things. This is a piece called Twilight in the Wilderness by, again, another contemporary composer who actually, I believe, just lives up in the Metroplex area. His name's Christopher Tucker. I'll read what he writes. He says, Twilight in the Wilderness is a musical impression of the body of works created by Hudson River School and landscape painter Frederick Edwin Church. Living around the time of the Civil War, Frederick Edwin Church covered his well canvas with beautiful sunsets of the American landscape. My main inspiration for the commission was his painting, Twilight in the Wilderness, a work of magnificence and brilliance. The painting depicts a dark red sunset encompassing the lush mountains below, with a lone eagle perched on a tree branch on the lower left corner. So this is, it paints a picture, and it's going to use some birdsong that starts it off, some wonderful solo work by many of our talented players. So we hope you enjoy Christopher Tucker's Twilight in the Wilderness.
Thank you. Thank you.
Alright, here's the exciting part we've all been waiting for. This is so much fun. And they put it together in one rehearsal, which is just really great. And the kids are fantastic. And the community of the course is awesome as always. And they've had a lot of fun getting to sit around each other and get to know each other and drop things on the floor and stuff like that. This first piece we're going to play for you is something slow and pretty. It's absolutely gorgeous. It's fitting for this time of year because of Veterans Day. It's from the movie picture, We Were Soldiers. It's called The Mansions of the Lord. It's this huge hymn chorale that they sing at the end of it. And if you get a chance, get on your DJ on the way home and listen to the chorus singing the words of this. And it's absolutely just breathtaking. It's a wonderful arrangement, something for band. So we hope you enjoy our combined performance. Oh, by the way, we call this a concert Youthful Atmospheres, because we have youthful people and people who feel youthful, who maybe not be as youthful as they used to be. But we had a piece called Twilight in the Wilderness, and In Autumn Skies, In Heaven's Air, and we had this kind of atmospheric feel to it, like lovely, thought it was fun. So Youthful Atmosphere, we hope you enjoy your evening with us. Here's The Mansions of the Lord.
Thank you.
thank you once again for joining us this evening. We hope you enjoy this collaboration, this neat event that we get to put together. We're excited that our kids are in this kind of thing. You know, it's really everything that's on the stage right now is everything that's right with public education in the state of Texas. We have some of the great things going on in regards to music education. We couldn't do it without phenomenal support that we get from our administration on our campus and also centrally in central office, and also from the high school. Joey Lucida, the head director from Lehman High School, is here. So we want to thank him for being here this evening. Where's he at? But we're very lucky to be in a very supportive school district for the arts, to have a wonderful place like this to perform in, and also have neat collaborations like this. So thank you so much for letting me borrow your kids on a daily basis, because it's fantastic, and we hope you go and kind of spread the word about the good things that they're doing, and then also this community, man. And if you have an inkling to be a part of it, we'll be more than happy to welcome you in. Our last piece this evening is a fun closer by Robert Foster called Bravo.